protests raging in Egypt amid warnings the country could collapse. Still, lawmakers in Washington just killing an amendment that would have banned the transfer of fighter jets and tanks from the U.S. to that nation. Kentucky Republican Rand Paul, the senator behind that amendment. Senator, thanks for joining us. Now the amendment that you wanted passed, it failed today. Tell us about the amendment. What were you trying to do?
This amendment would have stopped the transfer of F-16s and of Abrams tanks to Egypt. You know, you've seen those pictures of tens, if not hundreds of thousands of people riding in the street. Does that look like a stable country to you? Combine that with some of the comments by President Morsi that were translated to say that Jews were bloodsuckers and descendants of apes and pigs. It doesn't sound like a country we should be sending our most advanced weapons to. I don't understand the other side. The other side up here, I think just they're so used to doing one thing. They're so used to having unlimited money, and they're so used to the fact that they think we should buy our friends. They just keep doing the same thing, but I think it's wrong.
Senator, so many people approach me in the street and say, what are we doing? We can barely pay our own bills. We're sending F-16s to Egypt, and we're not even sure what Mohamed Morsi is. Is he Muslim Brotherhood new? Is he the old faction? What is he?
Well, and here's the thing is that if you polled this question, I think 80% of the people are with me that we shouldn't be sending weapons to Egypt. But if you take a vote up here, 80% of the senators voted against me. But that shows you how out of touch they are in Washington. And it also is a good reason why we ought to have term limits, because frankly, these guys just don't get it.
Senator, what's their point? Why did they vote against your amendment banning these F-16s? We need to make sure the country stays stable. Is that their selling point?
Some people see it as a make work project. They say, oh, if we give them money, they'll buy weapons from us, and that creates jobs. But if that were true, why don't we give all of countries around the world money to buy our cars too? We could sell a lot of American cars if we just print up money, send it to other countries, and tell them to buy our products. It's foolish. But then some of them say, well, they won't let us use the Suez Canal. My response to that is they should want us to use the Suez Canal because there are fees for going through the Suez Canal. They should want to be participating in trade because we send them food because they can't feed themselves. So we don't have to pay England to be our friend. Why do we have to pay Egypt to be our friend? And I think before we send them anything, they should act like our friend and not burn our flag and let a mob get on top of our embassy and chant death to America. I think it's a huge mistake to send them weapons.
Senator, I'm guessing that one of the countries that is very concerned about sending F-16s to Egypt would be Israel. Where are the pro-Israel lobbies on these F-16s going to Egypt?
It's quite interesting. I've talked to a lot of the groups, and a lot of people think there's only one pro-Israel lobby. There is one dominant one, but there's many others. And there's also members of these groups. And I guarantee if I went to any of their general membership meetings, the pro-Israel Americans are with me on this issue. But they need to call their leadership, because many of your pro-Israel groups are lobbying against me in Washington. They're lobbying for sending weapons to a country that very well could be an enemy of Egypt. I mean, an enemy of Israel, and has been an enemy of Israel. And I think if their membership knew that these people were up here conspiring in Washington to send more weapons to Egypt, and then Israel has to have then more weapons times two, I think most pro-Israel Americans would be upset to find out some of their lobbying groups are lobbying against Israel's best interests.
And sir, I point out the one I'm thinking of is AIPAC. If I'm not mistaken, they were in favor of these F-16s going to Egypt. Is that right?
You better ask them directly, because that's been a little bit murky today, and we've been trying to pin that down. But my understanding is phone calls were made from AIPAC lobbying for weapons to be sent to Egypt. So if you're a member of AIPAC and you prize our friendship with Israel as I do, I think you need to call your leadership here and say, what in the heck's going on, guys? Why would you want to send planes to Egypt to President Morsi, who's an anti-Semite who doesn't believe in the Holocaust? So I think their leadership doesn't represent their membership, and we plan on trying to get that word out.
Senator Rand Paul, thank you so much for joining us today.